And good evening to folks watching on KTLA.com on the streaming app. You're watching a pursuit here of a stolen vehicle through south end of Los Angeles here. We're on Central right now, getting ready to turn that back out to the west, east here from Central. Getting the, anyway, it's a pursuit of a stolen vehicle, been going on for quite a while. You see the LAPD air unit right there just coming overhead. It's been going for quite a while down here, so right now we're just kind of keeping track of it as it goes through here, working back east out towards Alameda, and we'll get you the name of the street here in a second as we go along. But now turning southbound, this is going to be, I believe, Wilming, into the gas station here, whipping around inside the gas station. Yeah. And swinging around, taking a look here. All right, coming back. And coming back in, you see a guy stopped in the gas station right here. I'll get the intersection for you in a second as I bring in here. Seven going to pull out to your north. You see the officers at gunpoint here in the gas station. They're holding him at bay. They're holding back behind their cars, just giving him commands to get out of the vehicle. You see southeast units directly behind him, the LAPD air units with the 18 on the trunk lid. And there were some gang units that started this pursuit as it got going. And then the black and whites dropped in and started helping out as well. Avalon and Coden is the location we're at here at the Arco station. So they got a position here and kind of watching what the officers are going to do. This is pretty much the most dangerous part of the pursuit at the end here, is they have to react to what the suspect does. As you can see, they're not really cooperating, reaching around inside of the car. You see him kind of bouncing around through that back window. And the officers will hold back and give him verbal commands to get out. You see, he's digging underneath the passenger seat, according to the officers on the ground, so that's not a very good thing. You see something just come bouncing out of that driver's window, hit the ground there, and now his hands are coming out. Yeah, I can't tell if that's damage on the left side of the car or what's going on. And apparently sideswiped a semi during this pursuit, so... Right now, it's wait and see what's going to happen here with this suspect. We're just watching here as the officers hold back behind the unit, trying to get him to come out of the car. They will not go up on the car. They try to get them out of the car. So it's up to that guy right now just to basically cooperate, follow the instructions of the officer, and get out of the car and not be digging underneath the seats and bouncing around inside the car. You see here, he's got his hand stretched out, but a lot of damage to that car right there, as you can see. Hit a few things during it. We're hearing he sideswiped the semi at one point going through an intersection. But right now, now goes the passenger door, and the glass from the window just dropping to the ground. So he possibly cannot open that driver's door due to the damage done to it. See the officers lined up. Once again, they are more than likely giving him verbal commands to get out of the car with his hands up in plain sight. And then they'll have him stand up, turn around, raise his shirt to make sure. As you can see now, we're still at a standstill here. Guy just pushed the door out some more, hands out where they can see him. You see the officer down in the lower right-hand corner giving him verbal commands and visual commands to raise your hands. And here he comes out the door, hands up, walking back, hands out. All he needs to do right now is cooperate. That's all he needs to do. And this will end peacefully. It's all up to him at this point. But officers have to deal with a situation like this, not knowing. Oh, there was a beanbag round just hit him in the stomach. You saw that. The round go off. And that's what happens when they get the cooperation level raised up a little bit with a what they call a less than lethal round. It's 1 ounce of lead inside of a Kevlar bag that comes out and it hits you. And you know, it is very, very painful, but it does get your attention and gives you the encouragement to give up. And that's what's happened here. You see the officers moved up. Arrest teams took him into custody, controlled his arms, his legs, and now are handcuffing him. And suspect now in
Okay. The driver, we believe that is the driver, moving over to the right side. Passenger compartment. Hands are out. Hands are down his side. That's never a good sign. They want those hands up. Screaming at the officers. Being very uncompliant. Now, they do have less lethal weapons at their disposal. You can see the officer down on the right-hand side believes he has a beanbag shotgun. That will be deployed on that suspect if he continues to not be non-compliant. He just got hit in the stomach there with the beanbag, and that's all he was interested in doing. That's exactly what they did. They deployed the beanbag shotgun into that, came from the right side, into the sternum of the suspect. They're going to take that suspect into custody. And officers will now clear the car to make sure there are no additional suspects in the car or in the trunk. But you saw the suspect come out, did not want to comply. Facing
custody, this car completely wrecked during this pursuit. It was a very high-speed pursuit at times, wrong side of the street, through intersections. Avalon and Corbin. Avalon and Corbin, suspect there in custody. You can see none for the worst of wear. I'm sure he'll have a nice bruise tomorrow from that less than lethal, but otherwise, you know, better the alternative. Yeah. Alec 5 is right behind you. So another peaceful end to a pursuit here. Suspect not injured. Luckily, we didn't have a way he was driving. You see the condition of that car. He sideswiped and hit different things, but we're not hearing reports of any major accidents with him that you could have had in a situation like this, but fortunately brought him to an end here at Corbin and Avalon at the ARCO station. Stolen vehicle being pursued by Southeast detectives from LAPD. The officers you see here searching the vehicle, see them sometimes when they do steal vehicles, they'll use them for crimes to go out and commit robberies or burglaries. And officers will then inventory the cars to make sure there's no obvious evidence of crimes. looked like a piece of the car. I'll slide over and try to get a peek at it here. Nine, five, slide towards you just a little bit. Okay, try to get your plate there and stuff in the trunk. There's your plate. Let's see if I get steep on it. Do you get it? Okay. She's got it. Yeah, you can see the side of the car is all bashed out there. That's what's hanging out. Full took off that whole left front fender, just cording it back. Yep. See it? So it looks like it just accordioned that left front fender, just peeled all the way back. You see the damage to this car. It just peeled the door right off. That's why he couldn't get out the passenger door, driver's door. All right, anything else you need? Did he crash into anything anywhere along the line that we go back and look at? Or? That's right here. That's just south of us here, so let's go take a look. We're on Avalon, and 97th is down here where the wires are.